welcome, and thanks for joining us live on our platform that is Fairplay Off the Pitch channel. And if it's your first time to be on this platform, kind of do one thing: subscribe and tap on that notification button for all of these updates whenever we come online. And again, if you have subscribed and you always pass by to just see and watch our videos, we are so much grateful to you, and keep doing the same. Well, my name is Shalom Lekuro, and today I'm going to bring for you something new. There is an athlete profile. Many of you out there, you're a fan of an athlete whom you don't know much about them, and you would really like to know. So today with me here, I have brought a professional footballer by the names of Tekkwo, Derrick, and he once played for the national team Uganda Cranes, and he was also the captain for Uganda Sand Cranes, and currently he's playing for Kona Rangers in Kenya. So I'm not going to talk so much about him, and I'm not going to introduce him, so I'll let everything to him, and he tells you who he is, so much detail about himself, and then what he does and how life has been with him, you know, how things that would like to know about him. So to some of you who might not know what Fair Play Off Pitch is all about, this is a non-profit making organization that promotes athlete values, and we reach out to the vulnerable communities. So that is why we have decided to come up with this profile of athletes speaking about themselves, and this is what Fair Play Off the Pitch does. Once again, if you haven't subscribed yet, please tap on that notification button, subscribe. You will be notified whenever we come on platform. Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Yeah. So could you please tell us something little about yourself, or maybe your name, and what currently you do in the company? Something
like that. Okay. Thank you very much. Shalom, Fairplay. And to all our viewers, I am very glad to be on this platform. For some reasons, I am part of Fair Play, and I'm so excited for this initiative. My name is Tekkwo Derrick, and I'm a professional footballer, currently trading in Kenya with Kona Rangers. I'm the captain of the current dimension team. Sorry. And it has been fairly okay.
Mm-hmm. So yeah. I think about that on Kona Rangers, yeah? Mm-hmm. Yeah. You people played well, and you have succeeded to go to another level.
Yes.
Of football. How do you call that level in Kenya then?
Oh, in Kenya that is the National Super League.
Wow.
That's called the NSL.
Okay.
Yeah, they're promoted from the first division. I managed to lead the team.
Oh, you're the captain?
Yeah, I'm the captain of the team. Even the current captain, even when we are promoted. Yeah. There are normally changes after that, but I'm guaranteed my position is still in check.
Okay.
And it has been a really good run.
Okay. So since you have talked about you being a member of Fair Play, yes, Off Pitch, your viewers and your fans would really like to know, what position do you hold in Fair Play Off Pitch?
Okay, thank you for that question. It's really enticing to answer. I am basically the disciplinary,
okay,
head of disciplinary.
Okay. And so people in the organization tend to misbehave. That's where Mr. Tekkwo Derrick comes in.
Yeah, that is when the lion comes in.
Oh, okay, that's interesting.
Yeah. So I am the project director, assistant, with my colleague, woman, perhaps maybe I might not mention due to reserved rights, but that's my post at Fair Play.
Okay. Yes. Yeah, so your fans out there who have been watching you, they would really like to know how Tekkwo Derrick, the name Tekkwo Derrick, came out. You could maybe tell us your previous teams that you've been in, the teams that you've been playing, and then the current team, some stuff like that. Just some little history of your football.
Okay, thank you. So who is Derrick Tekkwo? Yeah. Derrick Tekkwo is a renowned footballer in the country, okay. Uganda. Okay. And I started my footballing career way back in the 2010s. As a young teenager who was inspired by the legends in the country playing football, I kickstarted my career in the big league of Uganda. But before that, I was introducing myself from Hoima, that is Hoima FC. By then, I even promoted that team when I was still even in school to the Super League in Uganda. Unfortunately, I could not play because I was limited to studies. So, with time, I joined a team called Chirayang. I played there for almost 4 years, 5 years. That's the same team that I joined to the Uganda Premier League. So I managed to captain that team as well. At 19 years old, I was a captain. And at 19 years old, I broke through to the national team. That is 2015. I was at the Uganda national team. That is the Uganda Cranes.
Wow.
I managed to become one of the young upcoming good talents. I played at the Uganda Cops.
How old were you when you were in Uganda? 19. Oh.
I was 19.
Okay.
I've never fixed my years.
Wow, that's so good.
Yeah, so to date, I make 26.
Wow.
27.
Okay.
And I've never stumbled with my years.
Wow.
And it's just lovely to enjoy the best of your years.
Okay.
So, talking about my journey to my current state.
Okay.
From Chirayang, I got attracted playing the ball. I went to the beach.
Sand Cranes.
I managed to be the captain at the Sand Cranes.
Wow.
Our first outing at the Uganda national team Sand Cranes. I was the first Ugandan player to score the first goal for the Uganda Cranes. That remains in the books of the history.
Oh.
Not going anywhere.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So I played all African games under 23, the Cubs, the national team. There are some moments that you can't forget. But it has been really inspirational. And I think that's a brief background of where I have been within Uganda. So a few to mention, the clubs I've played for in Uganda. I have Chitara, I have Oima FC, I have Chirayang, I played for URA, I played for Express, I played for Toro United. Then that's when I decided perhaps I need to change the nature, and perhaps I breathe some more air outside maybe the country, and I decided to go and train in Kenya. That's where I am right now, with Kona Rangers in the National Super League, Kenya. Brief background about
that's
my
so wonderful.
Career.
Okay, so someone out there would really want to know what motivated you to become a sports person.
Okay, thank you. I think everyone in Uganda knows that football is one sport that you can't go unnoticed. We have a lot of talent in the country, not surprising to me. So as a young child, there's only one thing that could motivate you to play football.
Okay.
Either it is your parents, they are poor, or they are rich, and they are willing to support you, and it will work either way. For my case, I had my father. He played in his 8 years. He didn't play too much, but it was really a morale boosting. Whenever he came to us, he would encourage us. our mother didn't know much about football, but she was supportive. Regardless. Yeah, so basically, since my primary level to my secondary high school up to the universities, I've been playing football, and that has been a motivation for my life and the sports itself. So playing football without paying a single coin, there's a certain way itself it drives you to achieve something in the sport. That was just self-motivation.
Okay, so what other sports do you love aside from football?
What other sports?
Yeah.
Personally, I do some swimming.
Okay.
I love watching people swimming. Since I actually got inspired at the beach when I was playing beach soccer, I love beach soccer.
Okay.
I can still play up to date.
Okay.
There's some sports I would love to perhaps, you know, play maybe if I'm not doing football. I don't know if cooking is a sport, but if it were, I would be actually impressed to be one of the, you know, the cooks doing the sport.
Okay.
Yeah, and then I love watching rugby.
Okay.
So I don't want to be involved because of their violence.
Oh,
I feel the sport is
that strength energy used when someone just comes and jumps onto you.
Yeah, I know.
To get that ball.
Some
yeah.
people believe. The sport I do, my style of play is also aggressive, but it's not as aggressive as rugby.
Yeah.
But I love watching this one.
Yeah,
I think those are some of the few sports outside football
so,
that I love.
Briefly, could you please tell your fans who Tekkwo Derrick is outside his work, outside sports? Who is Tekkwo Derrick?
Tekkwo Derrick, aka Mofasa.
What's the meaning of Mofasa? It's one of the common ones you always use.
Yeah, actually,
so.
Mofasa is my name.
Uh-huh.
Mofasa means the king.
Oh,
yeah.
Which language? Rastafarian language?
Mofasa is a Zulu.
Oh.
It's a Zulu language.
Okay.
Which means the king.
Oh. Okay, I get.
Yeah, so I believe I'm in the king in my own kingdom. I don't need to rule anyone. I am a Rastafari. And I believe in ruling myself. So I am a king of myself. My own kingdom.
Okay.
So I am not a king to anyone. I don't want to hold anyone captive.
I understand. So
yes.
Who is Tekkwo Derrick outside his work?
Tekkwo Derrick is one Rastafarian with very, I don't know, some of them people just look at him and feel he's aggressive. He's perhaps maybe very hard on people, but he has a different perception of how he sees life, and he's a humble person to nature. So I am humble to nature, and I fall in love with anything natural. That is the connection.
In life, there is always challenge, and however much strong or however much good you are, there is always that weakness.
Yes.
So, I'd like to know, what are your weaknesses, and what are you doing to improve that weakness? It can be in the field, whenever you're playing, or outside the field. So what are those weaknesses, and what are you trying to do, or what are you doing to improve on them?
Oh, thank you. That is a strong question. Actually, one thing I believe in, I think, as they say, no man is an island. I believe I'm also, I fall in the category of the same, you know. So I'm not an island either. So, and I believe if I have a weakness, my weakness is maybe if nature overpowers me, then I normally accept that this, what I can do, I can't do it. One of my strong points is I believe I can do anything, and it starts with only with myself and my brain. So if I fix my mind that I will do it, I normally go for it. I think that is one of my strengths. I have a strong belief if I can do something, I can do it. But normally that makes me a time crush, but I normally do it.
I understand. So, like in football, there are those key things that make you stronger or maybe makes you known. Like, let me say, you can be a very good lefter or maybe a very good header. I'm not so much into those words. So, what is that key point of yours that makes you a strong athlete and makes you believe in yourself that you can always do it? When you reach in that point, you will just make it. Or maybe when you reach in that angle, you just have to score, have to net. So what is that point of yours, the strength point of yours in the field whenever you're playing?
Knowledge.
Oh, I love that.
My knowledge.
Okay.
Knowledge for the game. I've been in this industry for over, I don't know how many, 15 years plus, maybe.
How old were you when you joined sports?
Sports? I was, I think, 7 years from the academy. This is just here in Zira. That was the Botanica Soccer Academy. You know, but I learned football from one of the greatest, you know, unknown icons in the football industry. The guy, my coach, has produced a lot of talent in his, you know, invisible name. But he is a good coach. So basically, I think it's my understanding of the game, and it comes with the experience.
Okay, when we talk about living healthy, healthy life, let's talk about food. Do you eat healthy food, and what are your diet? What is making you look strong? And how do you keep your fitness? How do you maintain your fitness? Because most athletes always end up being in injuries, or maybe health-wise, or maybe they lack exercise. So how do you maintain your fitness, and how do you do diet, like balance diet, healthy food? And if I might ask, according to you, what is a health food or health eating? To you, what does it sound to you?
I would describe for you that in a very good way, if I was a doctor, but unfortunately, I am the opposite of that person. So I think, I believe personally, if you want to be healthy and have a better good diet, you know, your body will always send you to eat the right thing. So train hard, always keep your consistency. Balance your books and training, then the food geometry will just work out itself. So personally, I train so hard, I think I can't miss a day without training. At least twice. If it is too bad, I train once a day. I think that has helped me to balance my diet, because my body will normally send me to eat what it feels like maybe I need to eat. But I would suggest you who's watching me out there, if you not follow my friend, because it's perhaps not the right one, you know, consulting with the health, you know, health workers will be perhaps, you know, more convenient. Then you know what your body needs.
So what kind of diet do you prefer?
Since, you know, most of our workouts and football itself requires a lot of energy. I think we need too much, many of proteins. Yeah, so I do a lot of, you know, beef, the ugali, kaunga.
Yeah, the favorite food in Kenya.
You know.
Okay.
Yeah, so I do some grains, some common things. I can't understand how they work in the system. I improvise with food. Some common knowledge. Yes.
So, what advice would you give to a young talent, let me say a child who is trying to come up and become a great star like you, who is looking at you as a role model? What advice would you give to that young talent?
You know, one thing I would urge, or perhaps advise an upcoming talent, is they need to have a consistency in whatever they're doing. You know, most of us, most of the players out there, they know they have the talent, they exploit it. How do you exploit your own talent? There are some things you skip, you know. Perhaps you might think you're too exceptional, and then you think you don't deserve to work to keep your consistency. But you work and don't keep your consistency. All thing, any one thing I would add you out there, you know, if you're watching this, believe in yourself. It starts with you. So if you believe in yourself, fix it in your mind. Then you will grab your body.
Okay, so someone out there, or maybe two young girls out there, they may be wondering, is Tekkwo Derrick single or is he searching? So are you single or?
No, I am a father.
Oh,
yes.
So how many?
I am a father to a son.
Oh.
From Zion.
That's great.
I have a Zion.
Okay.
A very big name.
Oh, but single.
I love my boy.
Oh, that's great. Oh, so any word for Fairplay off pitch? But before going there, Fairplay off pitch has come up with this campaign called Athlete Career Transition and Mental Health. There is life after, the theme is life after sports, preparing athletes for their life after sport. We tell them that however much they are earning right now, but there is always that life after sport.
Yes.
So, since you being part or member of Fair Play off pitch,
yes,
how influencing can you think that this campaign can help or maybe reach out to someone's standards and help the person to develop and plan for his future?
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you. Even my fingers feel like illustrating this.
Sure, no problem.
We call it athlete career transition.
Yeah.
This is one of the biggest projects we have in the organization.
Yeah.
And personally, I believe this is one project that can shoot from just being a project within Fair Play to a project that can benefit the athletes outside the project, outside the organization. And I believe Fair Play athlete career transition is one thing that has to begin from within players who are still active. If you don't necessarily need to first retire, you think on what you have to do after retirement. Athlete career transition is one of the most lethal projects that we have. And as I was saying, as footballers who are actively involved yet in the profession, this is one initiative that I would urge most of us to get involved in, given the fact that, you know, we don't know what the future holds. So if you don't know what the future holds, plan it now. So I think on that notice, preferably, we would look through things which would perhaps, what can you do as a footballer, even when you're still active? Others want to go to the administration of football. Of course, you can't do it when you're active, but these are the papers we set you for the future. So others want to do coaching. If you want to do coaching, maybe you want to be a referee. It can be, you can be playing football when you're inspired. These are not only the fields that you can hold as a footballer. Outside that profession of playing football, or outside the profession of the sports itself, there are other things you can do. You can become a professional, perhaps a motivational speaker or something. You know, you can be an inspirational ambassador.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it would help you after the career. So mainly, this is a project which we set up to see how we can change the life of a professional footballer outside the sport. So briefly, that is the small intent of this project, which I think it can be beneficial to all of us, inclusively I. So I think ACT is a very good project, speaking little about it. Yeah.
So you've been talking about Kenya, you've been talking even in Uganda. So your fans out there would really want to know, are you Ugandan or you're Kenyan? Because the name Tekkwo is not from Uganda, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh. So. Okay, I am I'm a Ugandan by birth, by origin. Okay. I am I'm a northerner. I come from Gulu.
Oh.
I'm an Acholi from Uganda.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm a Ugandan. All
so, any one word for your fans and Fair Play Offpitch, your organization?
Yes.
Yeah.
One, I think my fans, I would love to thank my fans for all their support. Always. You might maybe have 1,000 fans out there, you know, but the one or two who stand for you, and those are the specific fans I would say like to send my shouts out to, and probably, you know, there are those invisible fans you never see, but they, you know, they love to see you in action. You know, if I can't serve the sport in the best possible way, while I'm still playing, no. Still, I thank my friends for believing in me in whichever ways I've been, you know, trying to give them, to spread the love. I believe football is, you know, entertainment, and the love has been always there, profound love. And to my fellow colleagues, to you, my fellow colleagues out there in Fair Play, you know, thank you guys for the love. Thank you guys for spreading the love in the community. Thank you guys for coming up and, you know, lifting the spirit within us, the athletes, within those, you know, the spirit has been sleeping, but you have awoken it. So it has always been a blessing, you know, to have Fair Play. And since Fair Play came out, you know, you can feel there's something that is happening in your life. You're helping out in the community. There are some invisible changes you cannot see. You know, there are some blessings you get when, you know, help a community, help someone who is, you know, perhaps they can't get it. You know, you're helping them, and in return, I believe, personally, I believe the love you give reflects back to you. So if you give tiny love, that is the love you get, as tiny as you give, as tiny as you reflects back. So let's keep on spreading the love. We shall get much more. Yes, thank you.
Okay, to your fans, how do they reach out to you? Maybe your social media platforms. Could you please tell them where they can find you and share a little bit of your platform?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, sure. Sure. I think I literally have my info on most of my social medias. My social media handles on Twitter, at Tekkwo Derrick.
Okay.
I have Instagram, same, Tekkwo Derrick.
Okay.
Facebook, Tekkwo Derrick. I even have a page. Thank you guys for the love on the page.
Okay.
Tekkwo Derrick, it has never changed.
Okay.
Yeah, I think.
Thank you so much, and thank you for coming. It was nice hosting you. And looking forward to share more or hear more from you, Mr. Tekkwo Derrick.
Thank you so much, Shalom.
Okay. Well, that has been it for now. And thanks for being a very good viewer right from the hour we started and up to the last minute. We are so much grateful. And thanks for watching Fair Play Offpitch channel. And we are going to keep on updating you with more of this and bring to you different athletes, and you hear from them their story and what motivated them to become sportsmen. It will not only be on football or in football, but still in other games. So, well, once again, thanks for watching Fair Play Offpitch. And if you haven't subscribed yet, once again, kind will do. And don't forget to turn on that notification button to keep you posted wherever we come on board. My name is Shalom, and see you again next time. Bye bye.